pocket lint. Every time you plug in to charge, you are compressing this stuff more until a thick buildup is formed at the bottom of the port. This buildup grows until one day your charge connector becomes loose and eventually falls out. Beginning with the lightning style port, I've found an ordinary toothpick that is slightly modified works well for this one. I carefully shave it on two sides so the part of the pick that enters the port is no thicker than the stem of the charge plug that normally plugs into the port. If you find a skinnier toothpick, you won't need to do this step. Here, I gently lower the tip of the toothpick straight into the very bottom of the port and gently agitate the compacted debris to get it to lift. I like using a toothpick because it's non-conductive. Unless you have exceptional vision, you will need to use something to assist you visually. Make sure the toothpick is going straight in and not off to the side so as not to cause damage to those small contacts. Compressed air may work for this port, but if you don't have any, or the debris doesn't let go with air, the toothpick should work just fine. After loosening the debris, blow it out. You can blow gently using regulated air from a compressor or compressed air from a can, or if your mouth is dry, your lips, or the hollow tube of a pen. Now your charge cord connector should plug in all the way. Next, we'll look at the micro USB style port. This one can be tricky, so please pay attention to what I'm about to say. Over time, I've cleaned a lot of these ports for friends, co-workers, and family, and nearly always found the same scenario to be true. The larger open area of the port is relatively easy to clean using the modified toothpick method, or sometimes by using compressed air. Gently swipe loose the buildup while avoiding the contacts located on the tab, and blow the loose debris away. That's not the tricky part. Hidden right here, tucked way down at the bottom of the tiny gap, lies what so many people miss. Almost always, in my experience, exists a substantial buildup of compacted lint. If this gap isn't cleaned to the very bottom, they'll be left with a loose, wobbly charge connector or a non-charging device. Don't let it be you. I've had consistent success using old plastic packaging to get to the very bottom to sweep this debris out. Just make a simple sweeping tool by getting your hands on some old plastic packaging and make a cutout with scissors shaped something like this. You can make it the way you want, but this works for me. It's important to use plastic that is thinner, but no thicker than this wall of the charge cord connector end. If the plastic used is at all thicker, the tab will get shoved over, bent, or broken, so be careful. After the swipe, blow it out the same way I mentioned previously. Now your charge cord connector should go in all the way. Lastly, USB-C port. This port I found to be relatively easy to clean. This provides easier access for cleaning debris out, which can be achieved by utilizing the same shaved toothpick method. There are no small gaps in this design to trap lint, so just by gently sweeping to the bottom, the length of the gap on either side of the tab and lifting the debris provides good results. Gently blow out the port to finish things off. One other thing I need to mention about compressed air is sometimes compressed air will not work. If you live in a hot environment or a physically active environment, that pocket lint will be mixed with a bit of oil from your skin. This makes it very hard to get loose from the port with just compressed air alone. Please keep that in mind. I hope this helped you. It's been a while since the last charge port videos, but things have changed so much and these problems and details need to be addressed. If this video helped you, please share it. And for more videos you might find interesting, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one.